Thank you so much. Second time that I'm here. I'm happy to announce that once more I'm in Berlin. I'm doing something with Audi at the 9th of February, so we have something excited planned, which I'm not going to talk about. I'm also doing a collaboration between the Fab Lab Berlin and Victoria Modesta. She's a pop singer from Russia, and she has a prosthetic leg, which I'm designing a new one for. This is in collaboration with the company Ottobock, also from Berlin. So I'm combining my my trip to FASHIONTECH Berlin with that, which I really like, because it's always a nice moment to get to Berlin. My name is Anouk Wipprecht, and I'm busy with fashion and technology. I'm going to tell you a little bit about my background regarding to robotics, because there's a lot of other fashion already covered. So I want to give you a little lecture about the playful notion that you can do while creating, and also working with sensors and more robotic interfacing. So one of my designs that you already saw is the Dare Droid, which I created in 2011. It's a robotic, robotic cocktail making dress. So it's actually really making cocktails. So as you can see here in the front, she has a little holder, which is 3D printed, and she has a system on the back. And if you play a game of truth or dare with her, she gives you a little cocktail. So that's a really interesting interplay regarding to the use of systems on our body, and also letting these systems flow on a wearer into a social circumstance, for example, because she would be walking around and interfacing and interplaying with the guests that are around. Another of my designs is a smoke dress. A dress that has the notion of emotion, of being shy. For example, I'm standing here on the stage while I'm a nerd. Like, I don't really like to be in front of you guys, so I'd rather disappear. So what if I would have a dress that could do that? This is a dress that could dive away, a little bit like an octopus. And what you have is a collaboration with one of the car brands that I work with. It's a dress that creates a big layer of smoke around the model, so she can, run away herself in this gray dress. I'm really interested regarding to the notion of fashion, of what you can do with it. For me, fashion is something that is expressive and also longers for a communication. So through the things that we wear, we are creating a communication and an interaction with the people around us. And I like to make that more digital and electronic. For if you look into that, we have spaces around the body. For example, if I'm interfacing or interfering with somebody who is standing next to me, I have my intimate space, my personal space, so my personal bubble. Then you have the social environment and the public space where you guys are all in, for example. And these spaces I reflect back to my systems and also towards my sensors. So my designs are all sensoric, so they know what is going on around them. It's a little bit the notion of smart design or intelligent product design. For example, you have your intimate space from 0 to 45, 45 to 120, 120 to 360. And 360 to 760. This has been defined by Edward T. Hall in the 60s, who came up with the theory of proximics, which I take into consideration building my systems and using my sensors. So basically here you would have one of my designs, for example, the spider dress, and you walk up to it, and in these different stages, it's reacting differently towards you as an observer or a visitor in her space. And that's a really interesting idea of looking at fashion and looking at the bubbles that we have around us. So this is, for example, the design that already got presented to you, the spider dress. We tried to cut the spider dress here. It didn't work out because she had a bad day and got stuck in Portland, where she's hosted. It's a collaboration with Intel, so the spider dress is in their office. Okay. Yeah, so basically what it is, it's a mechanic 3D printed limbs on the shoulders. And as soon as you walk into the personal space of the design, it has two sensors in the front part. It's attacking you. And it's not attacking you once. It's attacking you in 12 states of behavior. So depending on how fast you walk up to it and where you're standing in the personal space of this design, it's attacking you differently. So that can be a sort of like really grabbing out to get you, or a little pinch. It can also go up and it does like na 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 na. So all these funny things are, we were able to program in this design to give it a little bit more behavior. Because yeah, having a system that just does one thing sort of, it's not really interesting. So that I could do based on the Intel Edison. I'm part of the Intel Lab, so I'm creating with their technologies designs. And yeah, that is how it looks like. This is some of the development we did within Intel Labs in Portland, in Hillsboro, so in America. So this is the frontal part of the design in where we were looking for the architecture, so the structure. It needed to mount around the body, so creating the upper structure, creating the geometry and the full design, which you can see here as well, like building it up, like architectural state almost. And yeah, this is what came out of it. We presented it last year during CES in the Intel booth, and from there it got invited to other places. The structure and the design of the legs of the spider dress, we also created little spider bots that were like following her. So we built an army, and it were now like these were like six, and I think Intel has now, if you go anywhere where they are, they're mostly, the spiders are mostly hosted at the maker fairs. Then you see like a whole army of them that are like dancing around and following stuff. And this is really cool about design, that you can do that, you can let it flow into the world and it starts to create its own life sort of. The thing that I'm currently doing at Lego, so I'm flying into balloons directly after this, is I'm working with a team of children and people who are working at Lego. For example, this is one of the spider dress that they came up with, that they recreated. And I think this is one of the most amazing things when I saw it. They just really tried to get the architecture in here and the mechanic parts and like program that thing. And this is really where my joy comes from inspiring and from motivating sort of others to do so as well. And I think that is a really, that's a really, really cool thing about creation and about, us being out there doing cool stuff sort of. This is something what I do my way. I do this with robotics. We have Pauline van Dongen, who comes next to, who is like more into active wear, where she's solving other things regarding to, for example, solar and energizing your garments, because that is something that is needed. And so this way, we all have our own research out there, because there's still a lot to do in this field, sort of, because only a few of us are wearing wearable electronics or things on our body that have batteries involved, for example. We still have to do things regarding to maintaining your design, like what happens if it breaks? Do you make it yourself? Do you go somewhere? We need to energize our designs. For example, what Pauline van Dongen is busy with, how can you energize like your design, because you don't want to run out? And the last thing is also washability, because how are you going to wash these things that we have around our body, sort of? But I think that is a cool thing that is happening now within the industry, that finally designers and finally scientists and engineers and architects can have this conversation with big companies like Google and Intel, and also the fashion industry, for example, to figure these things out. Because, yeah, in a way, in the end, we're all looking for what's next in fashion, and how to do that is to collaborate. And this is something that FashionTech Berlin, that I'm really, really thankful for, that you guys are throwing this. And also Lisa from Electro Couture, she's really steering up a lot here in Berlin. So you guys should be very, very proud of Berlin, because you fucking rock.